line, a lost and find, end of the game and overtime, drawing of a new design, drilling that one earth of mine, looking to the outward, speaking mind about words, absurd, blurred to the curb, walking along the verbs.
Do we have a problem? Now you better get your stank asses up out of here before I cause a nuclear holocaust up in here, fool. Let's go, fool, come on!
Hey, everybody, what is happening? Easterlish back with some more Madden 17 Ultimate Team gameplay. We're going to have two games for you here, a little back-to-back action. Starting off against a Cowboys squad. Going to have mostly, I don't want to say it's an all-Cowboys squad because I saw a couple players didn't belong. But for the most part, you can see he's putting it together. And we're going to have, you know, we got led by a lot of the Falcons players, I guess we got now on this team as we lose a big chunk there. He's not having that. He wasn't having that at all to start that. So we come out and I see we got a nice opening on the sidelines with Tevin. You know, he's got great catching stats and he holds onto that after the hit, so nice. We want to see on him come out here rolling out there. We're going to hit Mikey Evans on the big play. There we go, taking it in for six. That's what we want to see coming out and getting the score right away. So go out, run the 3-3-5 stuff, see if we can get going to start this off. And there we go, nice penetration out there. Leonard Williams and his like 98 block shed putting it down for us. So as we see, we go out, kind of got the routes locked down, and we change directions, and he just manages to beat me just a little bit there. I seen what he was doing, I just couldn't get the acceleration back up to keep up with him. And he's got DeMarco Murray out there with Ezekiel in the backfield running that two tight end. I mean, you know, I guess that's a fullback probably in the set he's running to have the split back formation. That's probably how he's getting that to work. So at 3rd and 5, just not having it though. We got Kawan Short playing in the middle. You know, we got some good stuffers up there in the middle. And on 4th, we play underneath and we shade underneath there, lock it down, get that ball back so we can go up, trying to get something going. But his run stuffing game was on point, kind of like mine was right there. But that's all right. I like to pass the ball, you know, more anyhow. And go out, hit Hopkins. Oh, man. Hey, you know what, though? We put the ball on the money. Get Matt Ryan there. He put that ball right on the money. We got lit up, but that's okay. We'll go back to that, and we're going to take it again for another touchdown. Mike Evans, similar play. I don't think it wasn't the exact same play, but we got a very similar result, man, and that's why it's nice to have those big targets when you're cutting across, you know, horizontally through there or through the back end of that defense, man. Click on, make those catches, make it work. So, 3rd and 3, he come out there getting this one fairly easy. I play more pass coverage here as the quarter wears on. I was getting close to half, and so he comes outside. That's all right. That's why I have night train. That's why I want the night train. I want one side at least. No, I got somebody heavy on that. And we go down. We take the middle routes out there, leave the flats to him. So at least he's taking that down, putting some work down on this drive, dude. But as we come down here, getting closer to the end of the second, he's gonna go out. Oh, I thought he'd take a launch, but he takes the mid route. I come back to that. Dude, I'm just late to see it, man. You know, that's always frustrating, but that's like slow motion when it happens to you. And then there's DRC. All right, you know, some guys will shed those. Sometimes DRC does, but that time he didn't. And this dude puts together a drive on it. So good for him. We'll come back out. We got a 2-minute drive. We can put up points in that amount of time. Should be no problem, at least getting close. At least a field goal, you figure. Run up the middle there, get Tevin going on the outside, and there we go, the tight end there. And some of these guys, I've already got kind of even changed out as I'm just trying to change the scheme here up a little bit. But, you know, I wasn't getting a lot of work out of Olsen, you know, really as his value was for. And we go, we throw a wide receiver screen at, you know, ourselves there, kind of match up. We don't get the touch, but we'll take the first on it. It's easy yards, right? So we go out. I thought for sure I had a touch right there, or at least close to it. But Barr with the hand in at the end. Very nice play on his part, but that's okay. We'll go out here. We'll get the up pass lead. That way we get that correct stuff again, and we get into the 5. So Hopkins on that play, he's made that work the last couple games real nice for us. So 20 seconds out there. Start making use of the timeouts in this one, and we're going to take that one in. Easy touch on that one. So we'll go up now 21 here to 7. Starting the third. He's going to come out. All right. There we go. He got enough speed, I guess, to get all the way around out there. If you start diving like I did, you know what happens. We go out and he's got the mid open and tries to get the one-handed catch out there, but we are breaking it up on the backside. Goes back to the run. That was a great call right there. I was definitely not in a run stuff formation. I figured when you're down by 2, needing the points, but he made good work of that. Here we go. Cutting back on those routes. He's going to get the one-on-one. And, whoo, man, you know, trying for that. But by the time he threw that, we had more coverage out there, so that didn't work out. And Peters really got to make that play into purple. He looked lost out there. He was in a perfect spot to make the jump, but he did nothing on it. So this time we click on after he makes that long pass, and we snag that one. And that'll be that for this dude. That's why we got one more coming.
If you're tired of starting over, stop giving up. Make your dreams come true! Just do it!
Alright, now here we go. We are in this dude's Super Bowl. Again, like, I swear, it's crazy how many, like, games I play or other people's Super Bowls or against top 100 players. And most people have 10 times the amount of games played that I do. I just, unfortunately, this year has been really hard for me to get a lot of games in and stuff. You know what I mean? I understand all the concept sort of stuff, so I can go out and be successful with limited games in, but that's really just what keeps me from doing that, man. Just the time to pump those out. So come out here on first, and as you see, I'm having trouble with my camera. The game camera basically is locked in to this horrible setting, and I'm doing everything I can. Right, every time that I clicked up and down on the D-pad and all that, it would pull up the receivers. And I take a time out there trying to get it stopped, come back, it's still doing it, and I'm just like, alright, well, I'm gonna, you know, trying to make plays here, and this is like, I'm telling you, this is a challenge. Go out and try and play a game like this, let alone against somebody in a Super Bowl, so you know who's gonna be a good opponent. And I'm like, alright, if this was a regular season game, I would have quit, but, you know, I'm in playoffs, he's in a Super Bowl, so I'm like, I'm going to have to deal with it. You know, it's annoying, but we have to deal with it. So, and again, it's when you're used to doing things like lurking and getting your pass plays, it's a really weird field of vision. You know, I kind of got a little used to it as the game went on, but right there, we have to settle for a 3 after putting the yards down. But yeah, I definitely am at a disadvantage, you know, here. So I go back in again. I'm trying to get timeout going to settings, but of course you can't even look. It just tells you what stuff is here. So I was like, I was screwed. I was just hoping somehow, you know, like kicking something, it just all started, you know, start working. But nothing there for me. As you see, zoom out, camera zoom in. I was like, did they change something? Like, what happened here? Nope. I'm just kind of screwed on it. So, you know, as I'm looking through here, I was like, I had pretty much give up on it at that point. But I was desperate to get out of that. Like I say, playoff game. And, you know, dude started thinking I was pulling some crazy stuff on him. I'm like, oh, I'm being recorded. Well, that's cool, bro. You're being recorded too, man. Little do you know. I never didn't let him know that. I was just letting him know. I ain't trying to pull nothing crazy. I ain't trying to glitch you out, man. I was just trying to get my screen out. But, you know, so that was that. So we'll go back to the game. Just have to deal with it how it is, man. You know, just whatever, man. At that point, you know how it is in the game. Just be happy I didn't get a freeze and take a loss because of that something. You know what I mean? So it could be worse, I guess. So we come out. We locked the run game up on that one pretty good. He's got that route again. I've seen that one. And he'll use that a couple times in the game. Sometimes I'll man up the right way on it, and sometimes not. But again, the field of vision, look at, like, you're playing defense like this, you're so far back, and it's like such a weird angle to try to, like, use her and stuff. As you see right there, I just completely blow that. I mean, it's not like I won't miss a play here and there, but, you know, sometimes I was just really off on it trying to get to people. I see missing the tackle there, like, whatever, okay. But again, you know, as the game goes on, you just have to get used to dealing with whatever the issue is. Man, that's Madden, you know. As he comes out, and we are at least locking him up there. He could have went around, but we get enough penetration from Deion Jones. We lock it up, and then he tries to go third down, man. We hit that with the goal line, lock him up. I'm surprised he didn't fumble, but, you know, it's okay. So fourth and goal, he's going to take a shot at it, but, you know, we're in the middle. So, you know, at this point, he's probably going to run an audible off to one of the sides, probably the power side. You know, we'll just have to go and see, and, you know, if we can take a little shift and crash to that side, if that works out for the defense or anything like that. As we see how I scrape around, and we get Quan Short breaking through and just demolish him on that one. So I ran a goal line before. Fourth down, I ran a cover two, you know, invert sort of one, you know, audible back and forth to you know, from a blitz to the cover two out of the 4-4. Both in a 4-4, though. We come out, so I'm stuck on the goal line, though, and oh my god, dude, at least Tevin is going. So I didn't want to run after that, because he's, you know, he's got a blitz on right there, but he's also crashing heavy, so I'm like, alright, not in a good spot, especially with this field of view. Come out, let's make a play here, but...
Oh no! We suck again!
Yeah, you know, hey, it happens, you know, that really unfortunate. So we're going to have a 3-2 ball game. He's going to get the ball back. We're going to come out, play some more lockdown, though. I mean, and we're scraping on the run. So, hey, you know what, we're still managing to play defense, you know. It's like I say, a little tricky, but I still was coming out being able to make plays on this. So keep it going, 3rd and 10, see if we can go out. And I'm running, as you see, running a lot of coverage, running our cross man. really should have had a user pick right there, but again, it's just really tough to get that distance down. Apparently, I was just off by a half a foot or something, but four down, dude goes for it, going to give us the ball back out here. But hey, you know, I mean, I'm not punching him in. I'm struggling with some of the stuff out here. I hold the ball. He just locked me down right there. On the outside, I was about to get open, but again, taking a field goal, two field goals on this one, unfortunately. But at this point, I was just hoping to get through. I didn't care if I won 6-2, 3-2. I was like, I just wanted to get out of here with a win and move on to the next game, you know. But, you know, again, just the spacing, really tough, the defensive stuff. So we'll come out here, and I'm just trying to hold the middle down, and that one, close. I was getting closer and closer as the game went on, so I was like, I figured eventually, man, I'm going to snag one. Even in this crappy view, I was like, eventually, I'm going to snag one on, dude. So 3rd and 8, going to come out here, going to throw one up. We're going to see if we can get this.
Thank you, sir. May I have another?
And there we go. It's about time. So, I mean, hey, for what it is, we're struggling. But then the blitz comes out and, all right, putting us down. So 2nd and 19 there. And I mean, they come even quicker, it seems, though. So we'll launch one up. We get Julio with that nice catch. He tries to go. I think he was going for one himself. So we get in front of him, make the play. We'll come out. We got, all right, here we go. At least we're getting a little momentum now on this one. But we're down to like 40 seconds, 20 seconds now. Hitting underneath again. And at this point, I had no timeouts. I wasted 2 timeouts at the beginning. And I end up taking a field goal here because I just couldn't manage the clock enough because I wasted timeouts because of the stupid camera thing. That is the excuse that I'm going to stick with. All right, so we move on to the 3rd here, and he comes out. Oh, he hits that strike again. I was kind of over there, but again, just not close enough, not close enough at all. And it, twice out there. I was having trouble chasing from side to side because the depth of stuff coming in. As you see right here, I got a little bit better that time, so at least taking that sort of route out. He went for it 3 times in a row, an awkward hit. If he was Tony Romo, he would have been injured for the rest of the season, but that time we come in and just killing it, man, just flying in through that one. Nice. 3rd and 7, though, making the play. So, like, I want to come down, then just whatever I do, play good defense, stop, dude, you know, because the offense I wasn't counting on, obviously, in this game. And floating out to the side, there we go, making play from Night Train, 3rd and 8, and there we go again. See, like, we're a mile away, and whoa, like, I don't even know what happened. Like, I thought I would have had the pick underneath. He sails the ball. Again, from those views, I don't know what's even going on there, man. Just crazy as we run into a hit stick, which, you know, what it is. I try juking so much with this guy, and juking is just so bad that you just eat a hit stick so often, man. Every so often, I'll make it work, and you feel good when you do, but it's just such a bad animation. We go 4th and 1. We run that. We get that one in there, so at least keeping the clock going. He gets the heavy pressure there. Tevin, see, at least fast enough to get around. Try a juke. Not advised there. That one was my fault, though. There was nowhere to go anyway. Even if I juked, I was going to get plastered. As we go, and now we've got the deep route out by the sideline. There we go. Get on that and take that down. And it's nice that they took away the banners, you know, and the new update, I'd say, for the user catch and then the power move and finesse. Those were actually the 3 that bugged me the most. So I'm glad at least they did some things right after the fact. Should have caught that ahead of time, but, you know, so what. So we're going in, driving down. And this one here, I felt good. At this time, I felt like I was putting a real nice drive. He wasn't going to stop me, but oh, okay, never mind. That hit stick actually paid. The first Tevin Coleman fumble, can't say it was his fault. I mean, I ran him into, what, 3-4 hit sticks, you know, so it's just what it is, man. That's just on me, but again, I'm blaming the camera for that on this one. Yeah, we'll stick with that, too. And go out, and we do get the Ed Too Tall Jones. You know he's going to make his showing out there, make a play, do his thing every game, man. He's like Lawrence Taylor from last year for me. So 3rd and 18 there, we got... Whoa! I mean, I had the dude on him, manned up within my zones. I don't know how dude caught that. Crazy. But, you know, whatever, man. We're going to all catch breaks in the game. So, 2nd and 10, roll out, catching some underneath stuff again out. So, going to have to get some sort of stop out here on defense.
Lurk Squad donation.
Dang, now that's what, those looping picks, that was, those are a thing of beauty, those are my favorite, I love that when that happens, so go out, we hit him with that one real nice, as we go, 2nd and 11, gonna come out, roll out, and just not enough, I was trying to get that up and over the sidelines, I just didn't, I think if I had my feet planted, I might have made that, as we come down, 3rd and 11, make the play, get up real close, but on 4th and 1, instead of running, he hits me with the blitz, you know, just cause that's just one of them glitchy ones, and I was not blocking correctly, so really should could have ran the ball, I probably would have had it. But he launches one-on-one, and oh man, the spacing, DRC spacing on that. I was trying to go for the SWAT, and it's better, I guess, I'm going to have to start clicking on and cutting underneath or something with those, man. Because, like I said, after the previous update, everything was just so weird with that. So, 3rd and 15 now, tied up, man. You know, I definitely do not want to be going to overtime with this game. So, we get Julio. Look at that, beasting up. Get off me, both those guys. We got Julio, 95 catching traffic, so we can handle those hits now and come down with the ball. And it's only fitting that he hit Julio on one side, and we come back near the end of this game and light him up with one also. So, again, I ain't afraid to get Colvin the ball. You know, just don't take the big hit sticks. But there we go, 3rd and 5, and we just strike. You know, again, not the smartest thing to do. It could have got a first laid down. But you know what? It gives him a chance to come back. He's got a Super Bowl. He gets a chance to at least bring it back, earn his Super Bowl victory if he can. So puts a pass out there. I mean, you know, he has all the advantage as far as I'm concerned here, man. This was a hell of a way to play a game. I do not advise doing it unless you just want to try just for the heck challenging yourself. But no. But he's going to come up, try to do that. That time we were waiting on Julio. I had two people on him, manned up an extra guy, zoned all over on that. We tip one up. No tip drill needed to come down with that. What a joke of a cam. Thanks for watching, guys. Peace.